You probably thought all footballers are like Cristiano Ronaldo, who stays away from soda, alcohol, smoking, and certain foods. You'd be shocked when you find out that there are so many other players who just don't care that much. And I bet you didn't know that Frank Lampard doesn't care either. See, there are several pictures of Lamps holding a stick here and there, not just during his playing days, but also in his managerial career. Sure enough, Lampard was one of the best midfielders of his era, and arguably Chelsea's greatest ever playmaker. He scored more than 200 goals for the Blues, and won practically everything there is to win. Let's not forget that he hardly got injured or substituted, which made him one of the fittest players on the planet. Now, I'm sure you're wondering how Lampard kept his game at the highest level, even with his smoking habits. Well, I don't know his secret, but whatever it is, it definitely worked wonders for him. I guess that's why they call him Super Frankie. But hey, not all footballers are as strong as the former Chelsea playmaker in terms of managing the harmful effects of smoking. Heck, there is one player who almost died thanks to the huge number of cigarettes he smoked per day. I'm talking about David Ginola, the French winger who made a massive name for himself while playing for Newcastle and Tottenham Hotspur. No one could dispute Ginola's ability on and off the ball. He was smart, sharp, and he could find the back of the net even with half chances. A total package he was, but he probably could have been more had it not been for his smoking habits. Yes, the ex-Tottenham man was known to consume several sticks a day while he was at White Hart Lane. Funnily enough, there were no issues at this point, as he continued working his magic on the pitch for the London club. But sadly, his health took a major nosedive later on. After hanging up his boots, Ginola smoked more cigarettes than ever before, which later led to a series of complicated illnesses. But the worst was yet to come, because while playing a charity match in 2017, he suffered a near fatal heart attack. How ironic though, because all through his professional career, he never had any cigarette-related issues on the pitch. But I guess his lack of cardiovascular training after retirement made him vulnerable to a cardiac arrest in his older years. All the same, Ginola had to undergo a quadruple heart bypass to save his life. And as you would expect, doctors warned him never to go anywhere near cigarettes for the rest of his living days. Yeah, Ginola's case was pretty scary. And players like Wesley Sneijder would be forever glad they didn't have to deal with a heart attack. On the contrary, the Dutchman claims that smoking actually helped him play better. Strange, but according to the World Cup finalist, Jose Mourinho let him drink alcohol and smoke cigarettes as he pleased during their time together at Inter Milan. Speaking of which, that was the best spell of Sneijder's career, because in 2010, he helped the Mourinho-led squad win a historic treble. Sneijder was unstoppable at the time, even with all the cigarettes he smoked, and thanks to his brilliance on the pitch, Inter were able to win the Serie A, the Coppa Italia, and the UEFA Champions League. Now, cigarettes might not have harmed Sneijder so much as a player, but it certainly screwed up his physique after retirement. Yeah, the Dutch playmaker kept on smoking after hanging up his boots, but unfortunately, the habit drained his energy, which caused him to exercise a whole lot less. You need to see how fat Sneijder became after retirement. You just wouldn't believe it's the same person. Now, one person who smokes, but doesn't have to worry about growing a pot belly just yet, is Marco Verratti. The PSG man has been caught many times with a stick in hand, even while driving. A good example of this was in 2022, when a video of the Italian midfielder smoking as he arrived at the PSG's training centre surfaced online. To make matters worse, he was caught in the act by a fan, who even advised him to hide a cigarette the next time he rolled his window down. But Verratti wasn't going to take advice from a nameless fan, so he popped a smirk and drove off. For now, Verratti's game is still on point, and so far there have been no reports of any health complications. So I guess the cigarettes haven't been taking a toll on him just yet. I'm sure PSG supporters will be praying that it doesn't, just as Real Madrid fans prayed hard that Zinedine Zidane's smoking habits wouldn't kill his game. Now, I'd be surprised if you didn't know that Zizou was a heavy smoker during his playing days in Madrid. The World Cup and Ballon d'Or winner never shied away from it, as he'd been seen many times smoking in public events. Somehow though, Zidane managed to beat the side effects of smoking, as he was still considered one of the best players in the world up until his retirement. Speaking of his retirement, you can bet $1 million that Jack Wilshere would be wishing he cut down on the sticks earlier in his career. If he did, I'm sure he'd still be playing professional football as we speak. But no, Jackie Boy loved cigarettes so much that he didn't care how badly it would affect his game. Wilshere smoking became public knowledge when he was still playing for Arsenal, after a picture of him smoking while taking a piss on the streets hit the internet. At this time, he was one of Arsene Wenger's favourite young prospects, and the French tactician wasn't going to tolerate that. During a press conference, Wenger said, and I quote, "I disagree completely with that behaviour. You do not do what damages your health as a footballer." The ex-Arsenal manager went on to slam Wilshere for smoking and pointed out that it was affecting his game on the pitch. But who does he think he is criticising Wilshere for smoking? In case you didn't know, Arsene Wenger used to smoke cigarettes too. Most definitely, Wenger was a known smoker during the early stages of his coaching career, although he called it quits as he started to grow older. Back to Wilshere, and the boy should have listened to his manager, because his once promising career faded into the shadows, thanks to poor performances that were caused by cigarette smoking. He lost form and just couldn't keep up with the pace of the game anymore. And after leaving Arsenal, Wilshere had to play for lesser clubs like Bournemouth, AGF, and even Serie B club Como 1907. He went without a club for a long time before deciding to go back to train at his former club, Arsenal. Sadly, cigarettes didn't let him make the most of his return either. So on the 8th of July 2022, he decided it was best to retire from football entirely. Currently, Wilshere coaches Arsenal's under-18 team, and I'm sure he knows not to smoke in front of the kids. Moving on, and Jack isn't the only ex-Arsenal player who loves to smoke. His ex-teammate Wojciech Szczęsny was also notorious for lighting up any chance he got. Yeah, Szczęsny was hailed regularly for his heroics in between the sticks, but at the same time, he was criticised heavily for going too far with his cigarette addiction. Did you know that after losing 2-0 to Southampton in 2015, Szczęsny was nabbed puffing some sticks in the showers of the dressing room? This incident sparked outrage among media personalities, as well as Arsene Wenger, who, as I mentioned earlier in this video, frowns upon smoking. Fair enough, Szczęsny got hit with a $20,000 fine for his actions. As for how cigarettes have affected his game, I'd say not much, as he still actively plays for Juventus in the Italian Serie A, as well as the Polish national team. Now, one player who's never coming back to his national team is Mario Balotelli, who, just like Szczęsny, is also an addicted smoker. The difference, though, is that the Polish keeper found a way to stop the habit from affecting his game, while Balotelli did not. It's true Super Mario was the man at Inter Milan, Manchester City, and AC Milan during his first spell. However, smoking caused his form to dip when he later signed for Liverpool, as he was a total flop for the Reds, scoring just one goal in a total of 16 appearances. His second spell at Milan was even worse, as he had the exact goal tally, but this time it was in as many as 20 matches. It's sad to see smoking relegate a talented player like Balotelli from the big leagues to playing for lowly ranked clubs like Monza and Adana Demirspor. Well, I guess those are the kind of teams that sign football legends who suffer from shortness of breath. So guys, which of these smokers surprised you the most? Be sure to drop your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel, because there's more awesome football content where this came from. See you in the next one.